I am Coach Mike McKay, and I'm here with Barb Lemieux, who's the CEO and president of New North Inc. As it might sound, being up in the northern half of the state, Barb is a big fan of outdoor activities, year-round of outdoor activities, so I'm sure she'll share some of those with us as we go through this conversation. Barb, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, Mike. Greatly appreciate it.
Sure. Tell us a little bit about your backstory. Where'd you grow up? Where'd you live?
Yeah, I grew up in central Wisconsin. I was born on a Holstein dairy farm west of Marshfield. Grew up in a family with five sisters and no brothers. So my parents having six girls, I became the token tomboy of the family. So probably that's where my love of the outdoors came into play. But lived there for a number of years and received my bachelor's degree from Lakeland University and my master's degree from UW Oshkosh. So my education has been within the state as well as my professional career.
Nice. I grew up in a family with three brothers and no girls. So not quite as many, but I feel bad for my mom. Felt bad for my mom. Okay, so as I understand, why don't you tell me more about New North? So it looks like resource intensive for entrepreneurs and businesses in the area.
Yeah, so we were created in 2005, so we're coming up next year on our 20th anniversary.
Nice.
And we were created by CEOs in the region that felt we needed an organization that could take a much broader approach as to how we recruit talent and develop talent in the region and how we attract business investment. So we are 18 counties in Northeast Wisconsin, population of about 1.3 million people, economic impact of about $82 billion annually.
Nice.
Very strong business connection.
And how did you become the president and CEO?
I was working for WEDC at the time as the vice president of business and community development and love the mission of WEDC. I had a great team, a team of around 25 individuals that covered the whole state to help build community and work directly with businesses on their growth strategies. And then minority business development, diverse business development, and downtown developments were also a part of our team. And I really wasn't looking to take on a different role. I was commuting. We live here in Northeast Wisconsin, north of Green Bay in the village of Howard. And because it was a VP's position, this is well before COVID, that, you know, the thought was you're in Madison, your office is in Madison. That's where, you know, our office is located. So I spent a lot of windshield time. It was 270 miles round trip. There were nights that I did stay in Madison. I didn't drive that every day, but the prior person in this role was retiring, and I was approached by the co-chairs of the organization and the executive board to come on. So here I am.
That's awesome. Can you tell us one of your experiences where somebody gave you a push or an inspiration to, you know, maybe jump up into this role, or, you know, somebody that had a big impact on you?
Thank you. Well, I mean, I think going way back, it probably was my grandparents on my father's side. They immigrated here from, at that time, Czechoslovakia, now the Czech Republic. And two of the most hardest working people I have ever met, and just really taught me to, you know, to follow your dreams, to have tenacity that, you know, going into a new country, you know, a new industry, they didn't know anyone, and to be able to make it a go of it. I think I learned a lot of my life lessons from my grandparents, which then was followed with my mom and dad as well, very hardworking people. I think on the professional side of things, I actually had a career in law enforcement prior to getting
Really?
into economic development, right? And at the time, it was the previous executive director of a chamber. She was retiring. She had been the mayor of the community, very well established. And she would be in her mayoral role. She would be at our fire and police commission meetings, and she would watch me as I was reporting out to the commissioners. And she took me to lunch one day. She said, "We just need to go to lunch to talk." And so she shared with me that she was going to be retiring and asked if I had any interest in taking on being the president of a chamber. And I said, "Marilyn, I don't know really anything about economic development.
Yeah.
You know, I've been in law enforcement." And she said, "You know, it's all about relationships, and it's about the collaboration." And she said, "I see that in you." And she said, "I see your leadership style." And so fast forward, I went through an assessment. It was like a 3 or 40 assessment with the other candidates, and I ended up getting the position. So pivoted. So ever for like the last 27 years, that's been my career, has been in economic development.
That's awesome. And what do you think your biggest leadership lesson just in that 25 years is, or 20 years?
Gosh, it's hard to boil it down to one, Mike, but I would say it's, you know, really surrounding yourself and developing really good people. It's building that team. There are virtually nothing that I do on my own. You know, so the success of New North, I credit to really the team that we've been able to build, you know, from ground up, the team that we have today, and our new structure, our new design. And so it's finding the right talent that is aligned with your vision, but being open to their ideas, their thoughts, and then making sure you're developing them appropriately where they need to be within their careers.
Sure. And how about a challenge, leadership challenge that you were gifted?
You know, I would say maybe in prior roles, just building that team, you know, going in, coming into an organization where you just really felt like I hate to use this adage, but people do use it. You know, you get the right people on the bus, then you get them in the right seats on that bus. But I think it's walking into situations where you really need to take a step back and say, in order for this organization to propel, these are the changes that have to be made. And then, you know, obviously making sure you have the resources to execute. So it's building the budget before you can build your operations plan. So
what's the number one, the next big thing for New North right now? Then I want to ask you a couple random questions about your interaction with business owners and what you think business is facing today.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Mike. From an organizational perspective, we have applied to be an accredited international economic development corporation. Our application has been received, where we will have a site visit in August. And if we are granted, which we feel very confident we will, we'll be the only organization in the state of Wisconsin to have this designation. There's about 75 entities across the globe in the world that have it. So we feel it's really, really important. It has helped us throughout the process, just in our overall operations. And I think then receiving this gives more credibility to site selectors that we work with, to talent that might be looking at the region, that know New North has gone through this rigor and receiving this prestigious designation. So that's coming up here in a couple of months.
That's super cool. So tell me what you guys are deeply into the business environment. And, you know, a lot of our people are finally shaking. It's like the dog wet dog, right? Like shaking COVID off finally. And, oh, hey, this thing ended 2 years ago now or a year and a half ago now. What kind of things are you seeing the businesses up there dealing with, leveraging? What's good, what's bad in the environment from the EDC perspective?
You know, I think we're fairly fortunate in that we're very diverse in our industry makeup. It is true that we're about one in four positions in our region are tied to manufacturing, right? And in us, that's a good thing because manufacturers are kind of at the top of the food chain. Sure. And so because of that, you know, we have strong construction companies, we have strong finance companies, we have strong insurance companies. You have, you know, as manufacturers look at their supply chain, what they need, most often they can find within our region or the state of Wisconsin. So it allows us to kind of weather the storm a little bit. Mm-hmm. When you have upticks and downturns in the economy, you know, what we're hearing is, you know, business is good. With the talent shortage has loosened up a little bit. It's by all means still, you know, an issue about how do we find, recruit the talent to our region. Although it seems like in speaking with companies, it's not where we were 2 years ago, where they could grow if they could only find 50 people, 100 sure. people, right?
Yeah.
So I think that has gotten better. I think part of it is, you know, we also market the region, and we have some very aggressive campaigns going on right now. For 3 consecutive years, our region has had positive net migration of 4,000 to 5,000 people per year. So we are a growing region. Mm-hmm. And so I think that has helped with some of the concerns from the business environment. I think the big thing now is just, you know, the adoption of technology. You hear a lot about AI and robotics and digital twins and things like that. And many of our companies, our larger ones, they've been out in the forefront of this for quite some time. But we're working with our partners on our smaller manufacturers that are part of that supply chain, but they don't have teams of dedicated people that work on technology enhancements. But we know it's critically important for them if they're going to maintain that customer, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I would say, you know, that is currently something that is being worked on.
And what would you tell startups or smaller businesses, business owners who are trying to figure things out on their own? And in particular, I agree. I see what you are talking about with the growth up there. We have been invited to Sheboygan and to Pierre, and it's a vibrant, like business is vibrant up north. So as you're thinking about those smaller manufacturers that are trying to break into that, what kind of advice would you have for them? What kind of resources would you tell them to seek out? Are they things that you all do already?
Yeah, I would say, you know, to not go it alone, right? So we know besides, you know, the professional consulting firms, your tax advisors, your legal firms, your financial, you know, bankers want to see you succeed. So there are so many resources out there with relationships that a startup company would need to be successful. And then beyond that, you have this whole entrepreneurial ecosystem. So you have mentors that are willing to donate their time. We do this through our new Launch Alliance, where we highlight a founder and he or she will tell their story. And most, we encourage them to focus on what's not going as well as you would like it to go. Let's start sure. there. And so, you know, whether it be, you know, mentors, coaches, financial resources, you know, location, market research, there's so much available out there that is free. Then you pile that on with the paid professionals that every day this is what they do. So my advice would be to just don't feel like you need to go it alone at all.
Great. Is there a question that you wish I would have asked you that I didn't?
Boy.
Always the surprise. It's always the surprise ending. Is there a question you wish I would have asked you?
Exactly. I think I'm good.
All right. Well, thank you for the time today and the insight into what New North is working on. And hopefully the weather sticks and it makes it an amazing weekend for you.
Yeah, the same to you, Mike. We really appreciate the opportunity.
Yep. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye now.